dedicated, determined, dependable, doggy, Debbie, dandy.
Good evening, I'm Lisa Rayam.
And I'm Russ Spencer, and this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News Prime Time.
Tonight on Channel 5 Eyewitness News Prime Time.
He's a superhero who's making a comeback on the Atlanta-based Cartoon Network. And like any other celebrity, he's updating his act.
We've gone from modern humor to postmodern, and this is sort of postmodern.
Tonight, Doug Richards takes a closer look at the new Space Ghost.
Dedicated, determined, dependable. Friday, February 23rd, this is Channel 5 Eyewitness News Prime Time.
When Eyewitness News Primetime returns tonight, tonight's closer look is out of this world.
Coming up next on Channel 5 Eyewitness News Primetime, a closer look at the making of Space Ghost Coast to Coast, produced right here in Atlanta. And later in sports, Jeff Hollinger gives you scores and highlights. Some teams lost, but others won. All righty!
New York and Hollywood still have an almost unbreakable lock on most popular entertainment, especially movies and television. But Atlanta is finally cracking that elite barrier. And one example is a surprisingly popular cable television show. It's been on the air for a couple of years now, but only began airing in its hometown, Atlanta, a couple of months ago. Well, Doug Richards joins us now with a closer look at the show and its enigmatic and animated star. Doug?
Russ, the show airs on Ted Turner's Cartoon Network, which only cracked Media One's Atlanta lineup a couple of months ago. It's getting decent reviews from critics, and it's got a pretty sizable cable TV audience. And it all centers around a make-believe guy named...
Space Ghost!
He was a masked, muscle-bound, Saturday morning good guy.
He was a superhero. He was a little on the pompous side, but that's the way all the superheroes were in the 60s.
Space Ghost calling Jan and Chase. Come in if you hear me.
Ran on NBC for a year or so and ran on CBS for a year or so. And then went away into the Hanna-Barbera archive.
Where it stayed, apparently doomed to superhero oblivion.
We're trapped in the maze of horror.
But revived by cable TV's Atlanta-based Cartoon Network.
So who are you again?
With a new production team, new voices.
Diary of a Mad Space Ghost. Portrait of Space Ghost as a young man.
And a new concept, created by a man named Mike Lazzo, who watched the original show as a kid and had a notion to rescue the doomed superhero.
And I think Andy blurted out the phrase, Space Ghost Coast to Coast, and we laughed. And that evening I went home and I just woke up in the middle of the night and wrote down Space Ghost Talk Show.
You're messing with me again, aren't you?
Nope.
We call this room the Space Ghost... Utility Research Kitchen.
This is where Space Ghost Coast to Coast comes together, where editor Tom Roche pirates animation from the old series.
All the elements live on this one tape. They're all here. We use this one 90-minute tape over and over again.
To turn his cartoon character into a talk show host with for real guests.
We start with just Snow, and then from Snow, we put the guest in. So what we'll do is we'll take this shot, we'll take the mat and key that right on top. Now, there's Michael Stipe. Now, I put him in a box where I can move him around. Then we move to this shot, and then Space Ghost and Michael Stipe are ready to carry on a conversation. Now, the interviews are done all over the U.S., all over the Earth, because all over the globe, I should say, because it's a Turner product. So wherever the guest needs to be, we plug him into a CNN studio.
Space Ghost is hiding something.
This group takes the interview and writes and rewrites a script around it. An artist creates some new pictures to supplement the 1960s animation.
So it's going basically from here to here in about seven drawings.
And Space Ghost Coast to Coast hits the air.
You're a musician. Sing for us.
But I got to do it in the key of X.
Musician Jonathan Richmond taped this during last year's Midtown Music Festival.
Do you have any arch enemies?
No.
Sure?
Yeah, I thought about it.
So you are sure? Zorak and Moltar are my archenemies. Zorak's the green one over there.
Hi.
And Moltar directs the show.
We've gone from modern humor to postmodern, and this is sort of postmodern. We're sort of making fun and making fun and making fun of making fun.
Hey, Zorak, why don't you do a song for everybody?
Nah.
You sure?
No, thank you.
Positive?
Nah.
You're messing with me again, aren't you?
Nope.
Okay.
Its creators call it recycling entertainment, taking a somewhat dated concept and giving it a 90s twist.
In case the guest is impolite to Space Ghost, sometimes the guest just has to get smashed into oblivion.
For the Cartoon Network, it's cheap programming that seems to have touched a nerve.
We're deluged. We had to hire somebody just to answer. The only thing they do all day long is to answer electronic mail.
Women want dates with Zorak. A little bit of everything.
Who do you think is a bad influence?
You mean on me or on the world in general?
Either. Oh, let's call the whole thing off.
You can't say Space Ghost is like this show, you know, or that show. You know, it's not. It ain't just like nothing. It's out there all by itself. And so there's no rules telling me what to do.
Things have a strange way of evening up, especially for poor misguided creatures like Cyclone.
We've done really well with scotch tape and bubble gum and an old cartoon. But the great thing is to do it here in Atlanta.
What about a bad influence on a proper diet?
Yeah, but then, what's a proper diet?
Yeah. Question six.
Next question. Who is the voice of Space Ghost? Answer, George Lowe, an Atlanta radio guy who sometimes appears on WNNX FM. Next question. Who was the original voice of Space Ghost? Answer, Gary Owens, the announcer from Ron and Martin's Laugh-In. Russ, Lisa, who are your archenemies? All righty then.
We're messing with you. Now I got it. That's funny. Well, do they have trouble getting guests for this show?
They did at the first when guests were figuring out that they weren't sure they wanted to be interviewed by a cartoon superhero. Yeah. And now apparently they're lining up at the door to...
When's it on? When can we see this?
11 o'clock Friday night on the Cartoon Network, which is in about 14, 15 minutes after Hollinger does his sports. You can tape in the heat of the night and watch the Cartoon Network.
Sounds like fun. They're certainly having fun making it, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Thanks, Doug.
Thanks.
Here is Jeff Hollinger, Coast to Coast.
I like that, Space Ghost. George Lowe is a talented guy. I knew him when he worked at Power 99 here in town.
Oh.
Really a very talented radio guy, and Space Ghost is good. Has nothing to do with sports, but here we go.
Tomorrow at 10 on Eyewitness News Prime Time, an exclusive interview with the only talk show host who wears a cape.
I am Space Ghost.
I am Zorak.
My name is Brad.
Now we'll be talking to Channel 5's very own Doug Ricardo.
That's Doug Richards.
Whatever. Doug will take you citizens behind the scenes of my wildly phenomenal program produced right here in Atlanta.
Go watch it, okay?
Tomorrow at 10, only on Channel 5 Eyewitness News Primetime. Greetings! If you think the X-Files is weird, wait till you visit the Ghost Planet. Tonight at 10 on Eyewitness News Primetime.
Five is four.